Hey everybody, how's it going? And my husband walks in just as I start. Everything okay, Ran? Oh, okay. All right. Hey, how's it going, everybody? Yeah, of course, live, that happens. But that just threw me for a loop. Welcome. Thanks for coming. I am live, and today is Sunday, so I talk about my weekly goals. And as of this year, I've also been talking about the things that are going on as far as sort of the anxiety, the social stuff, the isolation, just basically things that I've been going through during the week, because it can just sort of, like I say every week, I need to come up with just a blanket statement so that I have it ready every time, so I don't have to fumble through it. But these things that make you build walls up and isolate yourself. So this week I'll be talking about one of those things that I've noticed this week that I'm keep saying this week. Let me say hi in the chat and get my wits about me and mute my phone. Boy, this is a rocky start. If you're new, welcome. I'm Margaret, and this happens sometimes, right? Hey Henry in the chat. Hello Karen. How are you? Hi Shayla. Thank you for coming. And hi Jill, how's it going? Hello Lorraine and Joni. Hi John and Lisa Marie. Hello Carol's Gift Shop. Thanks for coming, everybody. Hi Vintage Maid. And I do enjoy doing this live because we really get a lot of good feedback, and we have a good discussion going back and forth in the chat. So if you never have caught me live, set your notifications up. Usually Sunday it's at 1 o'clock. I'll come live at 1 o'clock. So Central Time, my time. So anyway, all right. So hi Michelle and Lee in Houston and Sonia. Hello. All right. So if you notice, I changed the title. I changed it to workload paralysis because that sort of happens, has been happening to me this week. And it's one of the reasons that I started clearing out my room. That feeling of you've got so much to do that you just can't do it. So even though I've been working on my room, I've also been having that workload paralysis in other areas. And I just realized, like, oh my gosh, how long has this pile been sitting here? And oh my gosh, just these little things that start building up and stressing me out. And then I just can't do it. I'm like, no, let me go get on my phone. I need to see what's happening on Instagram. I need to see what's happening in the groups. And so I just like block it out. And then like it really doesn't go away, but I just am not looking at it. It's like, I don't see you, la 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 la, so hi, we've got some more people jumping in. Hey, Treasures of Robin Hood and What You Sellin'. Hi, Dwayne, how are you? Hi, Twin Red Dragons Brewery and Lemon Lily Shop. Hello, Cynthia. Yes, the struggle is real. Okay, so before I jump more into that, I've been talking about, talking about doing a video, talking a little more about my backstory with my history with depression and anxiety. And then I talked to a friend about coming on, another reseller friend that was going to want to talk about their stuff too. And when I sat down and was talking to this person and started just kind of like, oh yeah, this is the kind of stuff I'm thinking about doing the video on and sharing. And I realized I was having such a hard time just telling that person. I was like, how am I going to do this? So I think I have to take a step back and figure out how much I can share, how much I'm comfortable sharing, because I think there's going to be things that I just can't share. You know what I mean? There's just some things that are just too much, So, hi, Trisha. Yes, I'm so glad that you made it live. Kunzi Coons, refresh. Hi, Bearded Picker. And What You Sellin' says, question, how do you need to eat an elephant? Exactly, one bite at a time, even though I would never eat an elephant, ever. Okay, hi, Vicky Nesting. Hello, hello, Susan. Okay, so here we go. So the workload paralysis. Hey, Catherine, I know I keep saying hey to everybody, but that's just what happens. So here it is. So I've had so much on my plate that I just shut down. And I have a feeling that a lot of you can probably relate to this. And I do just like go over onto social media. I don't watch a ton of TV, but I'll just get on my phone and I just put myself in this spiral of this busy spiral where I'm like checking Instagram, check Facebook, check merch, check eBay, check Etsy. And then what do? Oh, check YouTube, check my comments. And then I start that loop all over again. Well, I could do this for an hour. 2 hours. And I mean, it just like, and respond to people here and next slide respond to people here and just go in this big loop all the way around. Just so I can avoid the like stress of the other stuff that I really, you know, really need to be done. So I have a feeling you might be able to relate. And it's not just work stuff. So I'm going to share, if you follow me on Instagram, I'm Texas Gal Treasures there. But I shared a picture of my bedroom, a picture from my bedroom and a picture from my kitchen. I mashed them up. Let's see. Oh, I don't have to. Oh, let me open them real quick because I can't. It won't let me just show you. So hang on. They're coming. I'm opening them. Open. So, okay, here I'm going to share now. So there's a picture here from my bedroom and from like right by my kitchen table. I have this little table. Okay. So can you see it? Okay. So here we go. So this top part, where you see this little box and stuff, this up here, this is the pile next to my spot at the kitchen table. I have this other little table, you know, where I keep all the kids' paperwork and just stuff. Apparently Walgreens, my little one has, you know, this, what do you call this thing? Like nebulizer, right? So he got this new nebulizer. I don't know where I'm going to keep this thing. So anyway, like, oh, here's some papers that my son needs to correct. Just pile, right? Crazy pile. And then underneath it, so there's this basket full of stuff, this blue basket. This stuff, I'm telling you now, remember when my cats had ringworm? This basket is full of stuff that I need to go through and clean with the bleach water because it was like the cats had been near it while they had ringworm, and I just can't bring myself to do it. Same thing with this brown box full of stuff. This was stuff that was in the office when the cats had the ringworm that I need to go through and clean. But wait, under this brown box right here, I'm not even pointing at it around here, this brown box, under that, there's another box. So it's just like, and it has been here, you know, you remember when my cats had ringworm all that time? It's been there that long. It's still sitting there. So I can't do it. I just can't do it, right? Why can't I? And I keep saying to my husband, when are you going to help me? Like, it's his fault. He goes to work all day, right? When are you going to help me do this? Come on. You just need to help me do this. I can't do it by myself. Come on. But then also, underneath our bathroom sink on his side, because we had the kittens were in our bathroom for part of their seclusion when they had ringworm. So all the stuff under my husband's side in the bathroom was stuff that the kittens had contact with. So I need to go through and clean all that stuff out. So just like, I mean, it's just paralyzed. I mean, I could have it done in a couple hours, right? Haul it all out to the back porch, get the bleach water, right? Take care of business, leave it out in the sun, dry off. We're good to go, right? But for whatever reason, I just can't get to it. All right, let me go check the chat and then I'll move on. All right, let's see. Okay, Susan says, I totally understand. Thanks, Sonia. Hey, Delinda, how's it going? Carol says, I can absolutely relate to shutting down. Yes, yes. Catherine says, yes. Oh my gosh, yes. Okay, good, good. I'm not alone. Thank you. Lemon Lily Shop says, I do the exact same thing. Going down the rabbit hole, Carol says, yes. Kunzi says, hey, I just watched last night. There are teenagers doing eBay and Amazon. I'm blown away. Oh, totally. Totally. Yeah. Are you talking about Yard Sale Hunter, right? That's his name. He sent me some stuff a while back. Yeah, he's been at it a little while, but he hasn't put out a video in a little bit. Yard Sale Hunter. He sent me some stuff. Anyway, he sent me some stuff a while back. It's back there. Susan says, busy work keeps you from stressing out. It's my dining room. Don't even get me started. Why do you got to bring up the dining room? Oh my gosh. The dining room. My dining room table, which why do we have two tables? I don't even know. Because we only use it for Thanksgiving and Christmas. So my dining room table now is like a Lego village. Because my boys got a lot more Legos for Christmas. And then underneath that table is all my Amazon stuff that has come back, that is more is coming, and then two big tubs of toys that my boys got for Christmas that they can't even get in. I won't let them take it to the room. They could probably get it in there, but I just don't even take them into your room until I get your rooms cleaned out. Yeah, This is crazy laugh, right? Ah, it's everywhere. It's everywhere, right? Sonia says, I've been watching you for a while. Maybe I can get a track like you. One box at a time. That's right. One box at a time. I have to keep telling myself that. Heather Lee, yes, thank you. Hi. Hit the like button, everybody. 63 viewers. Yes, we've got 9 likes. Well, that I can see. You make it seem more. I'm human. Okay, good. Let's see. Melissa says, just do a bleach wash in the washer. Ringworm is just a fungus, not actual. This is true. This is true. But some of the items are like seashells. You know what I mean? Like from our bathroom on the next to the windows, we had like these shells and things that, yeah. If that's the thing too, in the basket, it's not clothes. Because yeah, all the clothes and plush and stuff we washed, but the stuff in the basket is like Legos, because it was like stuff from under my son's bed. And then the cats had gotten under there before we realized that they had the ringworm and all that. Anyway, yeah. So maybe just throw it out. I can't throw out Legos. I can't throw it out. Okay, yeah, you're right. Maybe. No, I can't throw it out. All right, Michelle says hire someone for that. Hi, Myra. Double Diamond says I started eBay when I was 16 on my mom's account. I would let my son sell stuff if he wanted to, but he never wants. He's worse than me about letting stuff go. No, actually, I'm pretty good about letting stuff go. He's really not good about letting stuff go. Let's see. La la la. Yard sale 100. Yes. Nebulizer. Margaret, give the baby more water in their diet. Reason for asthma attack is lack of water. His is maybe isn't even asthma. This is another thing we're going through. He's how old is he? Almost 7. He'll be 7 this summer. So he's had chronic croup. So I just took him to a pulmonologist recently. So we're trying some different stuff. That's a whole nother thing. But I will for sure get him more water. But it may end up being something else. So we're trying to figure it out. Shayla says, I keep rearranging my 2 rooms that I use for eBay. I can never get them arranged right because I keep adding more stuff. Yeah, that just happened in here. You know how my room was? I was always complaining the family used it as a dumping ground. It just got dumped in again. So, yeah. Hey, Silver Hair Stalker, I must have missed you coming in. Soak them in a basin. Yes, yes. Order band. Good germ cleaner and I think Costco. Okay, okay. Stick the legs in a mesh bag and run them through the dishwasher. Which legs? Maybe I'm missing this something. Okay. All right. Plastic bag, blah, blah. Plastic tub, water, bleach, soap, done. Yes. That's how easy it is. I know it. I know it. All right. Here we go. Okay. So I'm going to move on now. So those are some of the piles. But then the other thing that gets me is my piles that are virtual piles. The Legos, not the legs. Oh man, I closed that window out. Hang on. Let me stop. This is how legs. All right, I'm going to screen share my virtual pile that bothers me. If I can screen share again. I'm using my finger pad because, you know, I dropped my mouse the other day and now it's not working and I hate using the finger pad thing, just so you know. But I'm doing it. I'm doing it. Okay, this is my virtual pile. This drives me crazy that I have 63 unread messages in my email. I don't know if I'm just one of those weird people that it bothers. So, and then I need to go through and like unsubscribe from like a bazillion things that just send me messages. But I get so like overwhelmed by having 63 emails that I have to go delete them. I just can't have them there. So I just have to let them sit. I just have to let them sit and then go through and unsubscribe. Okay, please in the chat tell me I'm not alone because it drives me bonkers. And my husband's worse. It doesn't bother him at all. So I'll look at his and he's got like 900 something unread emails. I'm like, what in the world, Randy? What's happening? Yeah, no, I can't. I'm missing, stick the cat. Okay, I don't know. So I'm trying to let them sit now so that I can go through and like go to all the ones that are just like spammy ones, you know, or ones that are, you know what I'm talking about, and unsubscribe. But I get this thing where like I just get to delete, select all, delete, you know, and get them out of there. So yeah, I need to do that. But then, you know, there's that, and then like my virtual pile of like, I need to respond to so-and-so. I need to respond to so-and-so. And I'll see the message and then I don't respond right away. And then it starts eating. Oh my gosh, they know you saw it because it shows that you saw it, but then you didn't respond. So they're going to think that you're ignoring them or you don't want to answer them, blah, 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 blah. You know, and I go into this like, oh, okay. Now doing this and talking about it makes me feel a little crazy, but I think it happens. Like I needed to get back. I think Jill's here. I was like, I need to get back to Jill. I need to get back to her about those. But we were out and like our day just went all over the place. Like, oh my gosh, Jill knows that I saw. She saw that I saw that I, her message to me. And I didn't get back to her like I said I would. And yeah, okay. This is, this happens, right? This happened. It's Silver Hair Stack because you can unsubscribe from me. I don't mind. No, it's not that. Okay, so, but that is one of those, like, when I say this workload paralysis, like, okay, those things just hang on me, you know? And so finally, I finally did just message. I was like, I promise. I didn't forget. I just haven't been home to do what I said I was going to do. So, yeah, okay. I just wanted to put that out there. If you feel that way, or if you're waiting on a response from me and you saw that I saw it, I'm not ignoring you. I promise. I don't know, have kids and stuff. Jill says, no worries. You have a life. I understand that. It's okay. Yeah. Jenny says, I have so many emails. It's ridiculous. I finally gave up. I have 38,704 emails, but it's all junk mail. That makes me want to hyperventilate, Jenny. Right? Oh my gosh. Lee says, I go over a future return call in my head and later think I really did call. Yes. Yes. She's, I'll think I did it because I think this is what I'm going to say. This is what I'm going to do. This is what I'm going to write. Yes. And then you think you've done it, but you really haven't. Yeah. I totally get that. 100%. Okay. Now that I'm talking about it, it does make me feel, it's a very type A personality. And see, I don't really feel like I'm a type A person, but maybe I am. Maybe I'm in denial. Maybe I have one of those like schizophrenic personality types that goes different directions. Not that I'm schizophrenic. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that maybe on even days of the month, I'm type A. And maybe on odd days of the month, I'm type B. Or on leap years, I'm type AB, negative. I don't know. Sonia says, I wish I could live chat like you. It's because I'm good at talking to myself. You should hear me in the car. No, not really. I will put the camera on because I'll think I'm going to do a ride along. I'll do a vlog and I'll just talk to myself in the car. And then half the time I don't put it up. Oh, no. Okay. So now where am I going? All right, here we go. So piles around the house, boxes and papers. I showed you those. The piles in my workroom are getting better. But like I said, my husband just came and dropped a bunch of more stuff in here because he was helping me. He was cleaning the piles out of my car and he just put them in my workroom. So I can't fault him. He was helping, really. Yeah. And then let's see, emails. Yeah. Just normal stuff. Okay. So now, not just to talk about that, but like how am I going to try to overcome it? Because that's the whole point, right? What am I going to do about it? So one thing that I noticed that helps me is if I set a timer. And I've had people remind me of this because I'll forget about doing that. And somebody will remind me, just set a timer. Just see how much you can get done in 5 minutes. And normally it's, you know, the timer's, you're done before the timer ever goes off, right? So set the timer and see how much you can get done. Or just say, I'm just going to work on this for 20 minutes. And I bet in 20 minutes, you'll be way done way before the timer goes off, right? So I think that's something I need to remind myself to do. Set that timer and race myself and see what I can get done. Another thing I'm pretty good at, I didn't bring it with me, is making lists. And some days I'm great at crossing stuff off my list. And other days, not so much. But that's another thing that helps is just even putting nitpicky things. Don't forget to write on the calendar that you're going to go walk with your friend Brandy on Thursday, which would have taken me just as much time to walk to the calendar and write it on the calendar as it would to put it on my list. But I put it on the list anyway, because it's something that's been in my brain that I keep forgetting to put it on the calendar. So yeah. Yeah, so I make that list and then just like cross off every little things. And then if I do something that wasn't on the list, I go add it to the list so I can cross it off too. And I think I talked to Nick and Zahir about that, and they said, no, fair, you can't do that. And I was like, yes, I can. So it's still there. Okay, so let me know in the chat, what is something you do to help combat this? Because really, I'm not just doing this just to tell you how nuts my brain works, but to get some good ideas for me and for people who can identify with what I'm talking about. So in the chat, let me know and I'll read it off. And if you're watching later, leave me a comment in the comment section about what you do to combat this, like virtual piles or like just this paralysis of like workload paralysis of stuff, piles of stuff, or home, like home paralysis with piles of stuff that you just can't get to. And you just want to like do this, you know, I can't see you. Okay. So let me go through the chat. We three mason jar mamas, my hubby always asks me, how can you possibly have that many unread emails? Over 4,000. He gets uncomfortable seeing all the apps on my desktop. Yes. And I did that today. I felt so good. I cleaned my desktop and I went into my merch stuff and I organized all my merch folders because it was getting messy. But I did. I went through and I organized my desktop. Yeah. Let's see. Piles everywhere. Diana says, Green Pasture says, people pleasers can be confused with perfectionists. I wonder which one I am. People pleaser? Perfectionist. I can't raise the other eyebrow or I would. That would be fun. Okay. I forget to set reminders though, like says. We three mason jar mama. Some days I put things on my list just to cross them off to make it look like I accomplished something. Yes. Yes. Put the laundry in the wash. Check. You know, put it in the dryer. Oh, I forgot to put that on the list. Exactly. I do that. Yeah. Unless you're just putting things on there that didn't really happen, like skied Mount Everest today. Check. You know, planted 3 acres of corn. Check, right? Okay, take a deep breath. Okay, okay, good. Here we come. Tips. Diana says, I tell Google to put it on my Google Calendar. That's a good idea. Does Siri do that for me? Hey, Siri, can you put stuff on my Google Calendar? Let's see what she says.
You'll need to unlock your iPhone first.
Of course. She wants me to unlock my iPhone. But that means she can do it, right? Diane says, take deep breath and one pile at a time. Okay. Lisa Marie, my happy planner, write down the goals, writes what's for dinner, kids' schedule, etc. Yes. And I do that, and then I don't end up making what's on the schedule for dinner. Do you do that too? I do that. 1, 2, 3, get up and do one pile. That's good, Lee. Yes. Tammy says, I set small goals, small lists of to-do things, and that usually works. When you accomplish something, you're more energized to do more. This is true. That's what I say. Like, even I say to myself, just go over there and attack that pile of mail, like the mail pile, junk mail, right? Just go sort it out and, you know, recycle what you can and blah, 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 blah. That one little thing, right? Yeah, sometimes just little things can get you moving. Silver hair stackers, I have to put myself on a buying freeze once in a while so I can catch up. That's really hard. A friend of mine, Green Pasture says, Greener Pastures, a friend of mine calls the piles of stuff POS for piles of S. Carmel says, to do housework, I pretend I'm in someone else's house and getting paid by the hour and it works for me. I like that, but that would make me work slower if I'm getting paid by the hour, right? Diana says, planner gets pushed aside when I get busy. Yes, yes, mine too. Vintage Maid, what works for me is movement. I spend 30 to 40 minutes in one room, then move to another room. Yeah, and see, this past Tuesday, I did go in and clean out one of my boys' rooms, and then I found more stuff. So I have a little more work to do in his room, but it took me like 4 hours, a long time, you know, but it needed to be done. And then I need to do the other one. But then they found a big, one of those, I don't know if you live in Texas or if they don't have these where you live, but they had the big roaches, like, and we don't normally get like roaches in our house, but it was one of those like big ones that fly, right? And they found one in his room, not the one I cleaned out, the one I was getting ready to clean up. Okay. And so they found it in his room. And of course, my boys are not afraid of these things. They're just like, it's a bug. It's not its fault, Mom. And they caught it in a thing, and I'm getting ready in the morning to go take them. Yes, yeah, like a water bug, right? And then I see him coming with like a little plastic tub. Yes, palmetto bugs, and they like to live in the banana trees and stuff. I see him coming. I'm in the mirror, like getting ready for not for work, but for to take him. It was for chess club. It was Friday. I was trying to get ready. I was like, why am I putting on makeup so early? I was getting ready to take him to chess club. And I see him coming through the mirror with the plastic thing that they've caught it. And he's like, Mom, you want to see? I was like, no, do not take another step closer. No, right? Sorry, I'm yelling in your ear. No, you know, and so get that thing out of here. So yeah, they took it outside and they just think it's hilarious that I'm just, whoa. It's one of those things, you know, it's like one of those things. How did we get off topic? Oh yeah, yeah, because I need to clean his room. I would have never gone in there again if I found that thing in there. Lee says, oh yeah, Joni. She says, we have them all over Florida. I hate them. I used to live in this duplex and we had to park around back behind the house. And they had these big banana trees, you know, they're, you know, the big banana plants. Anyway, they lived in this banana plant tree, and I would have to run from my car to the back door to get into the house, and they would dive bomb you. It was horrifying. It was like out of a horror movie. Yeah, let's just say. It was terrifying. Michael says, my 65-pound dog is scared to death of those bugs. Yes, I would be too. He's a smart dog. It's a smart dog right there. And Quincy says, stink bugs are the worst than the fleas. Oh, yeah. Well, yeah. Okay, sorry. I get off on that. Oh, yeah, cleaning the room. Yes. Okay. So, keep the suggestions coming, and I'll read them out, or leave me a comment down below. We always get off, but that's okay. Diana says, one bug does not bother me. It's thousands of them, like the Temple of Doom. Yes. Yeah. Jenny says, OMG, I would freak out. When I lived in Washington State, we had wood spiders, and I saw one walking down the hallway like it owned the place. I freaked out so bad. You mean like one of those like big wolf spiders? Like we get those, like wolf spiders. But the spiders don't bother me so much. You know why? Because the spider's going to eat that sucker, right? Belinda says, you're describing my life. I'm happy to know everyone aren't like my sisters that I can bear myself to. Wear rubber gloves. I'm just so worried. There's another one in there. Usually they're not. Usually it's just a solo. Oh, gosh. Kristen's curiosities. When I was a kid, we lived in Panama. We used to make my brother change the TV channel. Hated the crunch underfoot. Gosh, that's so disgusting. Okay. Okay, moving. Yes. Okay, thank you, Lisa Marie. Focus on what you need to accomplish, not what needs to be accomplished. Thank you. All right, let's bring it back because I can't keep talking about this or I'll never eat again. All right, so this week I did host in the International League of Thrifters a organizing challenge because, as you know, I've been organizing my workroom, trying to move forward from the why we're talking about that. And we got some really good responses. I had people share their photos of their workrooms, befores and afters, and it was really good. It was really good. Can you see I'm struggling to move forward? And I finally got in what I ordered. Okay. I've been sorting my jewelry out, and I did a couple jewelry videos, and I'll show you one of them, what I got. Here we go. One of these things. Actually, I got two of them, but if I'm going to be honest, I really got four. But when I got four, because in my brain, I was like, oh, yes, this is going to be wonderful. I ordered four of them. And then I got four of them. I'm like, what was I thinking? So two are still in the box. I'm thinking I'm going to take them back. So I have two so far right now to sort. And I've already started sorting my listed jewelry into one. I'm still like trying to calm down from thinking about that bug. Anyway. Okay, Diana, bye. Have a good day. Diana's going to attack a pile. That's right. So I've been on what I like to say. I'm on sabbatical sort of from listing. So I'm still getting some sales, luckily, thankfully. I'm not listing right now because I just, I feel really good about where I'm at. I feel really good about and the pause to get everything kind of like hitting that reset to start over. I still have a couple tubs I haven't finished going through, and I want to get, in a good restart place. So I'm going to finish up that this week, crossing my fingers. I know Jeff challenged me to get it done by the end of the month, but I'm hoping to get it done this week. So when I get on it, it's good. But when I, stop, it's okay. Let's see. Lemon Lily shop. These problems are due to a mix of anxiety that and a need to control something. I'm obsessed with organizing, but the clutter causes me extreme anxiety. What works for me is just to do something, anything. Yes, I think this is true. Just to feel like you've done, right? You've gotten something done, right? Okay, so cleaning, organizing, working not just on this room, but also, as I mentioned, other rooms in the house. And then I think I may even do something like this because I have the other group on Facebook called Jewelry Lovers and Sellers, and we've had a lot of really good discussions going on in there. But I think I'm going to ask people, show me what you're doing. How are you organizing your jewelry? Because I'm doing this, but then some of the pieces are too big to fit into the thing. Here we go. Let me show you. Some of the pieces are too big to fit into the little drawer. Like some of the necklaces have really big pendants, or so I just want to see kind of what everybody else is doing. And I know, I can't remember who mentioned, put a cork, like one of those cork boards and hang the jewelry, the necklaces from that. But I don't really have a space for it unless I put it behind the door. But then I know what's going to happen. That door's going to swing open and hit it. And if I put it up there, it's too high. I'm short. Okay, so I don't know. I'm gonna ask. And then, I wanted to share a tip with you guys. So as I was cleaning out my junk jewelry, like I had from jewelry jars, like single earrings and things like that, I found, and if you didn't watch last week, I bought a pair of Kendra Scott earrings and a necklace at Goodwill for $3 for both, and flipped them on a local garage sale site within 2 days for 75 bucks. But so that got my brain like looking for them again. So as I'm cleaning through the jewelry, I found two Solo Kendra Scott earrings. And on this one, okay, it's sort of the shape. You can, it's they do this sort of shape. And then the name is stamped into it here. And then a lot of the earrings are kind of this style where it's, a frame, some sort of metal frame holding a stone, different colored stones in. So this is another one. Well, a friend of mine, I was at, and I posted these on my Instagram. And a couple people that know me, that like know me around town, follow me on Instagram as well. And she just from that knows what I do. So she saw me post these solos on there. And she was like, oh my gosh, I've been looking, I really want this pair of earrings. I said, well, I just found the solo, And she's like, well, if you lose a Kendra Scott earring, and you take the lone one back, the little orphan one back to Kendra Scott, they'll give you, they'll replace the other one and charge you half price. So it's like I could take this, because this is probably, I mean, I know it looks like this, but it's probably at least $50 pair of earrings because Kendra Scott's really expensive. So I could take this in, it was what, maybe a quarter or a nickel because it was in a jewelry jar. I could take this into Kendra Scott's, pay 25 bucks to get this both pairs. And then I could sell them for 50, right? So I mean, that's, you have to decide, look, $25 investment to make a $20 back, to make, so that, I mean, that's still pretty good. So anyway, but she's like, I've been looking for these, I really want this earring set, whatever. And I was like, shoot, I'll give it to you. Cause that tip alone is for me good. Because if I take this one in that I have one of that I was in a jar, was gonna go in a lot, cause whatever, I didn't know. And see if I can get, but I don't know if it, what happens if it's a retired, So if it's retired, what do they do? So I'm going to find out. I'll let you know. But this one I'm going to give to my friend Eva because she gave me that really good tip that I didn't know about. So Eva can take it in and get the earrings that she wants for half price. Awesome. And this one, I don't know. Part of me wonders if this is, I don't know. We'll see. We'll just see. Why is it coming up? Why is my finger blue? Why is my fingers blue? I don't know. Okay, maybe somebody painted on it or colored on it, and that's why it was like that. Maybe that's why my fingers are turning blue. Maybe I need to clean this thing up. I was like, that doesn't look like it's really, yeah, look. Ew. Maybe that's why they got donated. Maybe somebody's little girl like took a crayon and colored all over them. Yeah, I'm gonna clean that up and see what it's really supposed to look like. Ooh. Okay, next. What's on my so workroom? Okay, so as far as my business stuff, you know I'm not listing, but I am still making some sales, and I actually got a really good sale. So I'm gonna probably make still, try to make $250 a week on eBay and Etsy. So I think I'm still gonna make that goal, which is really good. And so I'll do my sales video tomorrow. And then Tuesday, I have let's see what I'm gonna do a Q&A video, and then merch talk is back on for Wednesday. I didn't do it last week because I had a quilting class. And then I'm gonna do something on jewelry on Thursday. I haven't decided yet what about, types of jewelry or something. We'll see, because I don't want to do another jewelry jar already, because I'm unjarring them, and I need to start listing them. And then I have a Harry Potter unboxing, and then I can't decide. Randy and I did a dumpster dive video, and I can't decide if I want to upload it or not. We didn't really find anything, but it was just us like going doing it just to see if, because we had never done it before, so he was really nervous to try it out. So we'll see. Maybe I'll share that. Okay, some people are sharing in the chat. Let's see. Sonia says, puts them in little baggies, the jewelry. I use sandwich bags for larger pieces and put them in a shoebox. That's a good idea. Lee says, I'm not short on fun size. I like it. I'm fun size. Kinsey Coons, cork board with push pin works for me. Clear hanging shoe bags. Oh, that's a good idea. Like over the door, organizer shoe bags. Right? Is that what you mean? Cardboard, Kinsey says. Vintage Maid says, our Salvation Army has so much jewelry. On Saturday, sale Saturday was fill a bag from the junk pile for $5. What? You could sell that to people in our groups. You just fill a bag for $5, jewelry, flip it for 10, whatever. Maybe more. Hey. Shayla says, jewelry makers may want to make pendants from individual earrings. I'm gonna lot some up to do that with for sure. And Belinda, maybe post the single earrings in hopes that someone has lost one and would love to make a pair again. That was what I was planning on doing with this one. And now I have to figure out why this one is all like that. I thought maybe it was just weird looking, but now I think somebody's colored on it. Okay, so, oh, hey, 75 viewers. Let me check. Hit the thumbs up if you haven't already. Okay, so as far as Amazon goes, the 15th is the day that the long-term storage fees go into effect. And you guys know I'm quitting, doing Amazon FBA for now, and in the way I've been doing it, because the way I was doing it didn't matter so much, because the long-term storage fees didn't really hurt me, because I didn't have multiples. Because it used to be if you had multiples, that's when the long-term storage fees really hurt you, but now it's everything. So I'm having a bunch of stuff recalled, but the problem is they haven't left there yet. So I'm wondering if they're still going to, like, I see the removal order there, but are those things, am I going to be charged even if my removal hasn't happened yet? They're, it's like, why are they dragging their feet? And then I need to call because I want to do a disposal order, but I can't figure out how to do a disposal order. Because I have a few things that's like not worth me sending them home, and I'd rather pay the 15 cents for the disposal order than the 50 cents. But I can't figure out, so I need to call up there. And yeah. Kinsey says, I thought you're not allowed to sell in the jewelry sales. No, this is true. This is true. We'll figure it out. I don't know. Let's see. Maybe, okay, yeah. Ba-doo. Yeah, I'm not. We'll see. I mean, we can just say, like, hey, she's got this good hookup. Anybody interested in my thing, Kunzi, with the people not want I'm not wanting them to sell in the jewelry seller site is that when sometimes people will slip through, because I try to screen pretty carefully, but sometimes people slip through and they just start spamming the group with like, come to my website, I'm having a sale on my whatever jewelry. Come to my website. It's just like real spammy. I mean, I don't know. Just make a oh. Joni says, oh, Jennifer says, hit me up. I can help you with a disposal order. Joni says, just make a removal order and instead have it disposed. I'm gonna have to look at that. Okay. And Jennifer, Joni, I'm gonna be talking to you because it's making me nervous. Like, I need a call. I can't figure this out. I kept playing with it and searching and like, how do I do make a disposal order? I don't want to get charged this, whatever it is. Okay, so I have a mini haul for you guys. Oh, and then merch, we used to be able to do, I have this in my notes here, I didn't even bring it up. Merch has dropped, you know, I was able to upload 4 shirts a day. It was 3 and then got all excited last week because they bumped it to 4. Well, now they took that away and I can do 2. So, yeah. Jennifer says, yeah, pretty much the same thing as a removal, but hit disposal instead of removal. Okay, I'm going to look at it. Okay, I have a mini haul. I didn't do a haul video with this stuff because some of it I'm keeping and some of it's just like, we'll see. I don't know. I went to an estate sale yesterday and I spent like $40-something. I got some geodes. My boys have already claimed there were others. My boys claimed the other ones, but I said, leave me one at least. So the geodes were, it's either $2 or $4. So I was happy with that. Some geodes, that's for me because I love my rocks and stuff. My boys want this one so bad, but I won't let them have it. And I have some more in my room, but I like to pick them up at garage sales and stuff. So I find them lots. Fossils, you'd be surprised. I find fossils and rocks and minerals and stuff. Hey, Jen, how's it going? Okay, and then, so what else I got? Okay, here's a tip. When you go to estate sales or whatever, or garage sales, and there's a sewing room. So here's what I look for. I look for patterns, some, like costume patterns. I look for, like, embroidery kits, sewing kits. And then another thing I look for are quilting rulers. They look like this. They maybe don't even look like anything. I bought this one. Quilting rulers can cost a lot of money. So this one, I spent $6 on this one, and this is a 9-inch circle wedge, and this one has sold for like between $24 and $29. So I haven't decided if I'm going to sell it yet because I don't have this one, and I need to check and see if my mom has it because they come back from their cruise today. So $6 for this is a steal, you know. So look for these kind of rulers in a sewing room if you go to an estate sale or whatever, garage sale, if you have that happen. Yeah, one of these acrylic, and I told Randy, I was like, look, this ruler is like between $25 and $30. And she was like, and he's like, what? It's like a piece of acrylic. I was like, for a quilter, it's gold. I'm just saying. Okay. And then I picked up this one without even really paying attention. I paid $2 for it. And then I realized there's no numbers on it. Is it centimeters? I don't know. So I'm going to have to take it to my mom because my mom is the, you know, better quilter. And I'll just say, Mom, what is this for? And she'll be able to tell me probably because it's not inches. That's, yeah. Anyway, but I just like, let me just get it. It's $2. Yeah, they're really expensive. Kunzi says, I have them. They do sell good. Okay. I am scrolling through the chat and I am reading what you are writing. Yay. Sveltsy stuff. Good. You caught me live. Quilters rulers are very expensive. Yeah. So keep an eye out for those when you go, because then a lot of times the people hosting the estate sale don't know about, they can't know about everything, right? And so that's, I think, something that's often overlooked as far as pricing those, and then the embroidery kits and things. Generally, I can get them pretty cheap because. And then I bought this men's accessory box for $1, and it's kind of scuffed up on here, but I'm going to still try to sell it. And then inside of it, I bought a money clip. I spent a little bit for this money clip. I spent $10, which for me, you know, is a huge deal because I don't like to spend a lot of money. But it is a sterling silver Mexico 925, and it's inset with abalone. And then it's got this Mexican or Mayan Aztec calendar, one of the calendars. So this one, and I saw one similar sold for like $30, but I think they underpriced it. I think I can get more. So I'm going to probably price this around 60. Yeah. And that's another thing. I can never keep money clips very long. They sell pretty quickly, you know? So if you see money clips out, pick them up. They sell for me pretty quickly. And then I got another pair of cufflinks because I don't have enough unlisted cufflinks. I really don't. I do. I have a lot. So, but I bought them because, and they, oh my gosh. So I was doing a ride along. Like I said, I do a lot of vlogs in the car that don't get uploaded. So I'll tell you what happened. So when I went in, the guy had like this box of watch parts, and they were like broken watch pieces and stuff. And I've sold watch parts before. So I was like, oh, okay, you know, I can make a steampunk lot out of that if the price is right. So I was like, well, how much for the watch, you know, the box of broken watch bits? You don't want to play it up. How much for the watch stuff? No. How much for the like broken box of bits here? Right? And so the guy's like, oh, when he picks up like this broken pocket watch, he's like, oh, this is $150 on eBay. I was like, oh my gosh, here we go. Right. So he starts humming and hawing about the box. And then he's like, $35. I was like, I'm going to think about it. So it didn't have that much stuff in it. So I walked off, went around, come back, get in line. Somebody else asks him the same question about the box. He does it again, picks the thing up. This watch is $150 on eBay. And then he's like, $100 for the box. I was like, I said, I should have bought it when it was 35. Yep. Yep. And generally, and I tease, but this particular estate sale company is usually really good. They're not one of those that brings in stuff. It's just what's there, and they don't try to hold it over to keep for the next estate sale. You know, they really are selling that person's stuff, and usually it's a pretty good price. So you just, but I kind of like it like that, where you like, you have to dig a little bit, you find really good deals, and then some stuff you're like, they're out of their mind, right? They can't give everything away, right? Okay. Quincy says, I found one of those boards that where you cut a rotary cutter for like $2, a big, big, big find. Yeah, and they had three of those there, the mats for the rotary cutters, and I almost got them. But the small one they wanted like $8 for, and then they didn't have the price on the bigger ones yet. But I was like, maybe I should have got them because those are pricey, those mats, and they look pretty new. Sewing feet for sewing machine accessories can be expensive, and they had some there, and I did that. I hummed and hawed about, do I want to ask them how much for these feet, the sewing machine feet? And then I was like, oh, I got enough stuff to deal with. So I just left them, but maybe. And Carmel says, if you ever find vintage knitting patterns, you can make them into a PDF and sell them on Etsy as a download. This is true. And I didn't realize this a while back. I was making this like sort of slouch hat, and I bought a PDF pattern off of Etsy. And then I found it again later. It was in the public domain, but people could do that. They could do it, you know? Oh, yeah. Kate says, I find quilters' rulers at Goodwill in the stationery aisle priced cheap. People don't know what they are. That's a good idea. I never even thought to look there for those because they can be expensive, right? Hey, Karen. All right. So then also I picked up another mastermind game. Give me the pieces. But this is for us because I bought a mastermind game. And I think I took a picture of it a while back. I was going to get rid of it. And I was like, no, we don't have it. Well, we went to play, and it was missing some of the pegs. So I just really got this to harvest the pegs. It was $2. I'm harvesting your pegs. That sounds really weird. And then this was also in the sewing room. Organizers. Three of them are still new and sealed. They're like that. Floss organizers. They were $1 a piece. So they have little compartments. Yeah, that's what I got. So there, I got 4 of them because when I sort my jewelry, you know, during jewelry jar unboxings and other stuff, I can get it open. Then I have all these little compartments, right? I like it. And then also when I rings, like I'm not putting my rings that once I have them listed into the drawers, I like to keep them separated. So I have another one of these, the compartments are smaller. So I have another one of these where I put the rings in there to keep them separated from each other. Yeah. Once I get everything organized, I'll show everybody everything. Is that it? No. One more thing. I think that's it. And then this was in there. The lady obviously sewed. And I like strawberries a lot. So I bought this. I guess they're strawberries. This strawberry bag. It's reversible. Ta-da! And honestly, I was in the sewing room and I had all this stuff and I was like, I need a bag. And then I was like, oh, that's really cute. I like it. I'm keeping it. So that was $1.50. So pretty good. Is that it? I feel like there was more, but that's probably good. Anyway, Danny's mom, I got a big bag of jewelry, some gold, some silver. Annie and Alex was going to maybe do a video. You should. People love to see it. They like it. They like this. Oh, I did get something else. Here we go. This vintage labeler. And again, I just got this as well because I wanted all the tape. I have one of these, a red one, but we didn't have any more of the tape. So I was like, okay, $4. I want the tape because my kids like to play with it. That works. That works. And it actually works out because this blue one, it's not working right. It like doesn't advance the letters. And so you end up like punching on top of other letters halfway. But ours works really well. So we just needed the tape. Cool. Cool. Okay, so let me see. We got 70 viewers. Hi, everybody. 41 thumbs up. Hit that thumbs up button. And if you are new, hit the subscribe button, if you will. And if you enjoy my videos, I would really appreciate it if you would share it with your friends and tell your friends to come watch and come subscribe, because that would help me out a lot. And they can come and learn too, and I can get to know your friends, and we can all be friends together. And just, that sounds really hippy-dippy, but it's cool. Okay, so I'm going to run, wash my fingers off of whatever is on this thing. So I hope you guys found something useful out of the video today. And later, if you're watching this later, leave a comment down below letting us know what you do to manage these, what did I say, workplace, work pile paralysis. You know, what do you do to overcome all of that stuff? All right, so thanks so much, you guys, and I hope you have a great week coming up, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.